But
so.
over here you have missed it. That is why I'm asking. So when you get the solution, and if you're getting the value, you have to write over here that when limit n tends to infinity, then you get this. But you have not put the limit, and directly you have written the answer. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
And this 4/3, how you have got?
Because you have mentioned that n was n starts from 1 and tends to infinity. So by putting the value as n equals to 1, I got that value.
Okay. So what is the nature of this sequence?
Decreasing.
How you are getting it as decreasing?
In the previous class, you told me, ma'am, if the term a n plus 1 minus a n is
yes, you are right. Proceed.
I think will be greater than 0.
If it is greater than 0, then it is increasing. If it is less than 0, it is decreasing.
It will be decreasing.
Okay, fine. So is that sequence converging sequence?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let us come to another problem. So we did a bounded sequence. Yes, any question?
But ma'am, the sequence is increasing, I think.
Ma'am, but it is also bounded above.
Yes, an plus 1 minus an, if you do, it will, the value is positive.
Yes ma'am, yes, the value will be 1 upon 3 to the power n plus 1.
Yes, you are right.
Also, the lower bound should be 1, not 4 by 3.
No, no, not 1. No. Because it is starting from 1, no?
Yes. The first term is 1.
No, no. How many terms are there?
We are starting it. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
First term is 1 plus 1 by 3.
Yes, there are n plus 1 terms. So, first term is the first two terms.
Yeah.
Okay. And it is increasing because when you apply this formula,
you're not audible.
Yeah, no, I have stopped because this was not working. So I had stopped. So you had this sequence AN as and so on. So when you take AN plus 1, so what you will get, there are n terms over here. So when you take n plus 1, that means one more term will be added to this. This is actually a series form. This is in series form. But collection of these series will form a sequence. Okay? So this is the nth term of the sequence. And when you take the n plus 1 term, so you have to add one more term over here. So you will have 1 plus 1 by 3. Up till n term, 3 to the power n, after that 1 by 3 to the power n plus 1. Now when you subtract these two terms, what will be left?
1 by 3 to the power n plus 1.
Yes, 1 by 3 to the power n plus 1. So this value is?
Greater than 0.
Positive, greater than 0 for all values of n. So that means this sequence is an increasing sequence. Okay, now in order to prove that this is a bounded sequence, so what you have to prove? This is increasing, so what you have to prove?
Whether it is bounded above or not.
Yes, so you have to prove it is bounded above or not. So how can you prove that?
By taking a limit and tending to infinity an. First we will evaluate the sum.
Yes, you first evaluate the sum and then take n tending to infinity. Okay, so what value you will get? You will get 3 by 2. And another value, when you take the sequence when n is 1, when the index of the sequence is 1, then you will get 1 plus 1 by 3, which is 4 by 3. So which one is larger? This is larger or this is larger?
3 by 2
is larger. So since 3 by 2 is larger, so this will obviously be an upper bound. Because the n interval, if we consider the interval AB, B is always greater than A. Okay, so this is the upper bound of the sequence and this is the lower bound. So this is a bounded sequence with lower bound 4 by 3 and this has an upper bound. But when you use this concept to prove that it is convergent, then you don't mix up this with the lower bound. Then it will be wrong. Okay, so you have to use the concept of increasing with bounded above to prove that it is convergent. Clear? So the sequence is monotonically increasing, it is convergent, it is bounded above as well as bounded below, that means it is a bounded sequence.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Is this sentence is true that every convergent sequence is bounded?
Okay, I'm giving you one example. Like this is converging to this point, again you get one sequence which is converging to this point. So what was your question?
Is it true that every convergent sequence is bounded?
Every convergent sequence is? Okay. Now you will get the answer from here. Like this is decreasing to some value. Again, this portion is decreasing to some value. And this is reaching to some constant value over here. It is converging. Converging means what? The first definition when I started, converging, it will converge when it will have a unique limit. The limit value should be unique.
Yes, ma'am.
So when it is giving a unique limit value, that means it is reaching to some value L, suppose. When it is reaching to some L value, that means it is obviously bounded.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
But if it is not reaching to value, like it is just moving downward or moving upward, that means it is tending to infinity or minus infinity or plus infinity.
Or minus infinity, yes.
Minus infinity. Then what will happen? It will not get a bounded value. It will not bounded have a certain sequence. Fixed value where it will be stopped.
Yes.
Okay. So the sequence can either converge to some unique value or it can diverge to plus or minus infinity. There may be a case like when it is converging, then it is obviously you will get some upper bound or you will get some lower bound. It may not be totally bounded. It may be bounded totally or it may be bounded from above or bounded from below. But there may be a situation where you can have that it is bounded but it is not converging, neither it is diverging. Okay, it will have, so in that case, you have a name which is called oscillating sequence.
Oscillatory sequence, yes.
Oscillatory sequence.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
It will neither converge nor it will diverge, but it will lie between some value because to converge, it should have a unique value.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, but it is not having a unique value. So the simplest example is minus 1 whole to the power n.
Plus 1, minus 1, yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Hmm. Okay, ma'am.
Yes.
Take an example of sequence which is n by n minus 2.
What n by?
N minus 2.
What do you want to say over here?
Like for n equals 1, it will give me a value. For n equals 2, it won't give me
a
value.
No, it gives, it is undefined. It will be undefined. That means you can have a, this will not form a sequence. You can have a sequence. If there is some limit, some condition over here, like when it is taking a value over here, when n is 2, then you can have some other value, which is called forced value that we are introducing over here, because it is becoming undefined. So this cannot be considered properly as a sequence.
So it will not be considered as a sequence. So no convergent, divergent.
Or ma'am, we can start its domain after 2.
No, it will start from 1. It will obviously start from 1, n equal to 1.
Okay.
Or there may be a sequence form like breakup step. Like you can have that an will be equal to n by n minus 2 for those values of n which is not equal to 2. And forcefully you can have some other value that it will take this value n when n is equal to 2.
Okay, ma'am.
But over here, the thing is that there will be a difficulty over here that you will not get a uniformity of this sequence. Like it will neither be a uniform form of increasing or it may be a uniform form of decreasing.
After n equals 2, it will be a constant decreasing sequence. Like for n tends to infinity.
Yeah, that only I'm saying. That means it will not be continuously increasing or decreasing. Like there will be some breakup point at this point too.
Yeah.
But we can choose so a value such that it becomes continuous.
Yeah, you can choose a value. If the function is such that it becomes a continuous and you can choose a value, then in that case, you can prove whether it is converging or diverging. Otherwise, you cannot show that it is converging or diverging. Like in this case, it is not possible.
Okay.
Okay, this sequence... How can you show that this is not a bounded sequence? This is a very simple example, minus 1 whole to the power n. How can you show that it is not a convergent sequence?
We don't know that any at infinity the number is, we don't know that infinity is positive or is even or odd. So we cannot justify that.
No, you can show that it is even or odd. It is not like, because n is equal
when,
to 1,
when
2.
When it is odd, it will give value minus 1. And when it is even, it will give value plus 1. So it is oscillating between minus 1.
It is bounded, ma'am.
Yeah, my meaning is that how can you show mathematically that this is neither a convergent or divergent sequence? That was
the difference. N is equal to odd 2 case.
Yes, you have to break this class, you have to break this index class into two sets. One is even set.
And one is odd set.
And one is odd set. Now, how can you prove? There are two ways. Either directly you can take the point 1, 2, 3 and then check the result.
We can take n by 2 and n plus 1.
Or other way what you can do, you can represent this number as even number. How can you represent a number whether it is as even number? You can take n, it is, you can take this index as 2n. So whatever n you take, then that becomes even. Because 2n is a multiple of 2, that means this you can this index is considered as an even index. And if you take it as 2n plus 1, then you can consider this index as the odd index. Got the point what I mean to say?
Yes, ma'am.
So
yes,
when ma'am. N tends to yes, infinity, ma'am. Limit n tends to infinity, a of 2n you can prove. So when this is a of 2n, limit n tends to infinity, you will get minus 1 whole to the power 2n. So this will obviously be 1 because this is even. And again, in order to prove the odd one, you can take limit n tending to infinity, a to n plus 1 minus 1. So this will be minus
1.
Now, since this is not giving a unique value, since this is not getting, because you know, for the convergence, you should have a unique value. Since the when you are taking the limit n tending to infinity, you are getting two different values. Okay, but these are finite values, so these are converging. Means if you imagine like this, that these are finite value, this is converging. If you consider only even set, but if you consider the overall set, then that is not converging, but that is oscillating between minus 1 and 1. Got the point?
Ma'am.
Yes.
When you will take minus 1 to the power 2n, it be indeterminate form mein aa ja raha hai, ma'am. 1 to the power infinity is...
By minus 1 to the power 2n, it is positive value.
Okay, ma'am. Sorry. So yes.
This is a positive. So this will converge. If you have the sequence like this, so this will converge to a unique value 1.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, now you consider one example. Test this sequence. 1 by sine of 1 by n. So what is the property nature of this sequence? So you have to prove whether it is increasing, decreasing, it is bounded or unbounded, whatever is this. It will converge or it will not converge.
increasing lower bound 1.
Yes.
Ma'am, lower bound minus 1 and upper bound 1.
Carefully you do it.
There is no upper bound.
Ma'am, divergent.
Okay, no, you do and you tell me. Partly somebody was saying right and partly it was wrong. Okay, let me tell. Okay, first tell me whether it is increasing or decreasing.
Increasing.
How did you prove it?
The sine value will keep on decreasing as the value of n increases.
Ma'am, it is unbounded, ma'am.
Unbounded from where?
Ma'am, minus infinity to minus 1 and 0 to 1 to infinity.
No. Okay, when n is starting from 1. When n is starting from 1, what you are getting?
Cosec 1 to infinity.
0, 1 by 0. It is bounded below and decreasing.
No, when n is 1, what you are getting?
1 upon sine 1.
Cosec 1.
Yes, so it is a finite cosec value. One. So it is bounded below.
And decreasing.
Bounded below, okay. So, now, when n tends to infinity, what you will get this value?
Infinity.
So it is unbounded above. Okay?
Unbounded above.
Now, whether it is increasing or decreasing?
Increasing,
ma'am.
Yes, it is increasing. So it is monotonically increasing. Now, whether it is convergent or not?
It's divergent.
No. Divergent.
Divergent. Divergent, ma'am.
Because see, it is unbounded above, but it is increasing, so it will not converge.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you take another sequence. Minus 1 into the 5. Like this.
It's minus n to the power n by n.
Minus 1 to the power n.
Yes, yes.
Oscillating.
Upper bound 0, lower bound minus 1.
No. Please unmute, mute yourself.
Ma'am, how you did you prove the previous series is increasing?
Okay. The one who said that it is increasing, how did they prove? Somebody told over here, it is increasing.
Ma'am, the value of sine is decreasing, so the overall value will be increasing.
Yes, that is one concept. And anybody else who have done the other way? Okay, can you apply this one? An plus 1 minus an. Can you apply this property?
Yes.
Can you apply this property over here to prove whether it is increasing or decreasing?
Yes.
By this apply, when you apply this, you will get this as a positive value. Okay, and now come to this part.
Lower bound is minus, upper bound is 0.
Upper bound is 1 by 2, lower bound is minus 1, and the series is converging towards 0.
Lower bound is minus 1, upper bound is 1 by 2. So this will oscillate finitely, okay, because you are getting a finite value. Sometimes it happens that it will give minus infinity, and the other time it will give plus infinity. So this will oscillate infinitely. So there are two properties in oscillating. One will oscillate finitely and the other it will oscillate infinitely. Okay, now you take this example.
Ma'am, in previous one, how can we say that it is oscillating between minus 1 and 1 by 2?
Okay, keep on changing the value.
Yes, it will go changing along with it. It's n.
Oscillating infinitely.
Yes, it will be oscillating infinitely. It's infinitely.
Yes, yes. Obviously, when n is 1, okay, you can consider this as...
But ma'am, the overall, the value will converge towards 0.
Right.
Yes, ma'am. Overall, the value which converges towards 0. 0 minus or 0 plus. But
yeah, but yes, the value is 0. Minus 1 and half only.
Half is the maximum value, I guess, which can
that is the upper bound, no?
Minus 1 is the lower bound, 1 is the upper bound. Half is the upper bound. And the sequence is going to 0. From both the ends. That's
ma'am, the sequence will oscillate between minus 1 and half, and at infinity times it will converge to the x-axis line. Means it is like an infinitely oscillating sequence.
See, Avya, what you will see, which value among these, which value will be larger?
Half.
Yes. So you will have half as the largest value. So you have half. And among this, which one is the lowest value? Among all the values, so it will be
minus 1.
So whenever there is, like, just imagine like a pendulum swinging. Okay, again this side it will swing, again this side it will swing. So this is actually the largest range in which it will swing, and this is the lowest range in which it will swing. Got the point?
Ma'am, like damped oscillations.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
The amplitude is decreasing.
Yes, it is decreasing. So that is one. Okay, now this one?
It's divergent and it's unbounded from both the
upper bound.
Yes. Unbounded divergent.
Lower bound is minus 2.
Unbound.
No lower bound, no upper bound.
Unbound.
Lower bound and infinity.
Oscillating infinitely.
Yes, oscillating infinitely. So all the properties you have done. Whatever I have taught, based on that only you will get the an exam, okay? Okay, now you check the convergence of this. Next day I will start the series. Okay, you have the sequence A is equal to... Now check the convergence or divergence of the sequence.
It's convergent.
Okay, just post the solution. How did you prove that?
By taking limit n tends to infinity, we get 2 by 3.
Okay.
Also, the denominator cannot be 0, since at n equals minus 3, it's 0. So, another way to check that.
Ma'am, it is necessary ki the value is coming finite, it is converging. It may
yes, it has to be a finite value and it has to be a unique value.
Ma'am, so was minus 1 to the power n by n finally converging or...
Oscillating. That's when I started oscillating sequence. What did I say? I said that it will not converge, neither it will diverge, but it will just oscillate. That is why the name is given as oscillating sequence.
This sequence is also oscillating.
This one, no.
No. Okay.
2 by 3, 2 by 4. Looking at the sequence, you can understand. Whenever there is any minus 1 to the n term, looking at the sequence, you can say that it will not give a unique value. Because when n is changing, this sign is also changing. One time positive, one time negative.
So to find the upper bound, we would take n as a infinity, but for the lower bound, we would be like putting the values of n, no? Like
Yes.
We would put putting the n is equal to 1 or n is equal to 1.
No, n equal to 1 because index is starting from 1.
Ma'am, lower bound 2 by 3 and upper bound 3 by 4.
3 by 4.
So what is the conclusion?
Ma'am, it is final.
Decreasing.
It is convergent and bounded, ma'am.
It is decreasing.
Converging.
Convergent and decreasing.
The upper bound of 3 by 4 and a lower bound of 2 by 3.
Yes. Okay, what about this? Minus 2 to the 5?
It's an oscillatory. It's not oscillatory, it's divergent, having lower bound as minus infinity, upper bound.
Yes, this is not oscillating because minus 1 to the power is not there. It's separately written. We can have a look at these books also.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
What can we say about those constant values, say an equal to 1?
Constant value. So it is getting, when n tends to infinity, what it is giving? Is it giving a finite unique value?
Yes, ma'am.
So it will converge. It will give a unique value.
Page number 248.
Please mute yourself. Who is that noise is coming out over here? You can go through this, whatever is given. Whatever I have taught, it is mentioned over here. Same thing, the sequence will be a real number when it is being mapped. This I explained to you. This is a constant, just like somebody was saying now, when it is 1, what will happen? So that is a constant sequence. Bounded, unbounded sequence. Convergence, divergence, oscillating sequence, monotonic, this I have also taught, monotonic sequence, limit of the sequence. This is using the epsilon property, but this for your knowledge, based on this, there will be no proof based on this, but just for your knowledge, you can study this, have a look. So another student was saying this question, that if it is converging, whether it will be bounded or not. So over here, there's the same thing, the property is here. I explained you graphically, but over here, it is done mathematically. So that's all. That's a little small chapter. Next class, I will start the infinite series. So you can have a look at some problems.
Ma'am?
Yes.
This last question which you gave, an equal to 2n plus 7 by 3n plus 9, is it decreasing?
Yes, it is decreasing.
How do we know that?
How did you prove? Did you prove it?
Ma'am, I proved it means I took that value, an plus 1 minus an.
Yes, you just put the value and see what you are getting. You subtract the value. So you will have a 2n plus 1 plus 7 by 3n plus 1 plus 9 minus 2n plus 7 by 3n plus 9. Now you simplify it.
It will give 2n minus 3 by 3n plus 2 by 3 into 3n plus 9.
Is it a positive value?
It is 2n minus 3.
2n minus 3.
By 3n plus 2, 12.
3n plus?
12. Into 3n plus 9.
Whole into?
No, in the denominator.
This will give a negative value only for n equal to 1.
But it is giving negative value for n equal to 1 only now. But if for higher values of n, it can give a positive value also.
I got the numerator as minus 3 only.
The function gives 3 by 4 minus at n equals to 1. And at infinity, the limit tends to 2 by 3. So clearly it shows it's a decreasing function.
Yes, ma'am.
Now you multiply this term. You simplify this term. Numerator will be minus 3 only.
Simplify this.
Ma'am, numerator is minus 3.
What you are getting? The one who was asking now? All of y'all are getting like this? Numerator?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So if it is negative, then obviously this is less than 0.
Yes.
Only minus 3 numerator.
Now, okay, you take this example.
Yes, ma'am, it is clear now.
It is clear now? Okay. There was some calculation mistake.
Yes, ma'am.
This is 1 by n. Okay, now you check this. Is this sequence convergent?
Ma'am, is that a factorial?
Yeah, factorial.
Ma'am, it is decreasing and decreasing function.
What about others?
Decreasing.
Posterior solution. Let me see.
And please open the question.
Is it possible to calculate its limit at n equals infinity? I don't know.
No.
It's not possible, correct?
No, not possible, yes. It is not possible.
then we'll go with the method an minus 1 minus an. Okay. Can you please show the answer? I don't know how to solve this one.
Anybody else?
No, ma'am.
Yes, it is not possible to solve. Yeah, it is not. I just gave it like that because in order to solve this, there is some other property that we have to use, and that is not in your syllabus.
I don't know how to break that exponent.
No, it will not be able to break this term.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. You can follow this book, or you can even follow the book which is given in your syllabus. Any question? Otherwise, I can stop here. We will meet in the next class.
No, ma'am. No questions.
Just go through the exercise problem for your practice. I will start series next day. So, okay. Just tell me the difference between series and sequence. What is the difference between series and sequence?
Sequence is a set of numbers and series is a sum of numbers.
Yes. Okay. Okay, bye.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
One doubt. Ma'am, you told minus 2 to the power n is not oscillating. It is divergent series. The necessary condition for oscillatory function is that you told the converging value, it is not unique. It means we are getting two values. Also.
Yes.
But
yes.
If we plot the graph of minus 2 to the power n, then it will like minus 2, then 4, then 8, then n. The sequence goes on. And if we join
all... Then minus 24.
It will reach to minus
infinity. Yes, ma'am. That will reach to minus infinity or plus infinity. But from 1 to n, it will be like minus 2, 4. And if we see the pattern of dots, it is like oscillatory dots only. So we are not considering that.
No, it is not oscillating. Oscillating means it will, because only there is one minus, no? So looking at one only minus, then you can understand that it will not oscillate. If it is minus 1 whole to the power n, then you can say that it will oscillate. It will not, because it will be stuck towards one region. See, oscillation means if you plot the real line, you will see that it is moving along the positive axis one time and it is moving towards the negative axis the other time.
Okay, ma'am, but we have kind of two types of oscillation. One oscillation is that in which amplitude is fixed, like the sinusoidal wave, and the other one is in which amplitude is variating. And it is keep on increasing. So this minus 2 to the power and it will be kind of like that in which amplitude is increasing.
No, obviously amplitude you don't consider. Actually, that oscillation is different. Like physics oscillation is different. I just, I was taking the example of pendulum just to make it clear what is happening in oscillation. But it is not totally... Because obviously amplitude is not counted. It is just a number.
Okay,
because when amplitude is counted, then there will be several other factors that will be added to the term. Okay.
And what's the definition of oscillation in mathematics?
Oscillation means it will reach to different values.
Ma'am, oscillation and alternating series are same.
Yeah, alternating series is means that is different. Alternating series, one way you can say, if you take it separately like a collection of series, then you can say that it is a sequence. But series and sequence are totally different thing. What got the point? Like you are saying that alternating series means if you just study the nature-wise, it is same.
Yes, ma'am.
Nature-wise, it is same. Because that is also taking a value which is means it is just moving towards one part and again it is returning to other part. Nature-wise, it is same. But in mathematical term, if you say that they are same, it is not same. Because sequence is totally different, series is totally different.
Okay. Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah, this part, over here, many students make a mistake. When proving it, they think that it is the same. They apply the property of sequence to prove for the near series. Or they apply the property of series in sequence and they do reverse things. So that is different. Mathematically, it is totally different. If you can visualize it, then it is, you can say that, yes, the thing is happening same, similar pattern. Okay. We will meet in the next class. Okay, bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.